Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, guys. World Mechanics. Today, a quick video, guys. How to properly inflate your tires. Every car is different, guys, and you have to make sure that you put enough air and not too much or not too less, because otherwise you can have a blowout. You can get in an accident. So we'll show you guys how to find the information for your tires and what you need to do. Of course, this is for stock tires. Okay, so when you open the doors, guys, on most newer vehicles, when you open the door, you'll be able to find a label that says tire and loading information. Okay, right here. And you can see for this Toyota Sienna that has 17 inch wheels. Okay, and depending on the tire size as well, front needs to be a 35, rear needs to be a 35 as well. If you go on the Fiesta right here, which is a front wheel drive car again, okay, you open the door, you'll find the same information here. Check it out. But there is a difference here. The front ones are at 39, rear at 36. Then we'll go to the BMW, guys. This is our 330 CI, as you know. And let's check the requirements for this one. It's a rear wheel drive car, so most likely the rear tires will need to have more air. And you can see the front requirements are 35, rears are at 42. Okay, so let's actually check the figures here and see if we've been running enough air in our tires or not. So we'll just go ahead and check on the Fiesta quick. We have to have 36 in the rear, 39 in the front. So let's see what we get there now. So we have that air compressor that we purchased, guys, which is a pretty cool deal. You can set the tire pressure and it turns off automatically. Okay, when you're done. Okay, so the Fiesta, right now in the back, it has only 28.5 and it needs to be a 36. So we're definitely not running enough pressure, guys. So what we're going to do, you just pump it up. Okay, you go to whatever pressure you want, okay, and turn it on. Okay, we need to wait for it to stop and it's gonna turn off. We'll check the front ones too, but it's very important to run the correct pressure in your tires. Okay, it's at 35 now. It should stop at 36, so let's just check to see if it will on its own. Okay, it's still 36, right there, perfect. So that worked so far, guys. We're gonna check the front ones. I have the feeling, because if you don't have enough pressure as well, you might notice that your tires get wore out on the inside or the outside sometimes. Okay, it could be alignment issue too, but ours is not. Ours is, we just drove them low and we didn't pay any attention. The front ones at 26, shame on us, guys. It's supposed to be a 39. Okay, 39 finally, guys. So we're gonna check all of them. I have the feeling that we've been running low. Let's check the vent quick on this side. Okay, just to see. It's supposed to be again 35. And you can notice a really bad fuel economy if you have low tires, guys. First, it's not safe. Second, you'll be using quite a bit of gas, 28.5. And we have a tire pressure sensor in the car, but it's going to activate probably at 26, so it doesn't really show us that we have a low tire. Okay, guys, so we just got the Beamer now, 42 rear tire. Okay, let's see what we have in that thing. 23.5, that is ridiculous, guys. That's really, really bad on our side. So we definitely need to check our tires more often. Check yours, because that could benefit your mileage. Safety first too. So thank you, guys, for watching. Please subscribe and see you guys next time.